In this video, I'm going to show you how to check who has access to a SharePoint file, but I'm also going to show you how to change it. Let's get into it. So to see who has access to a document, the quickest way is you could click on the three dots here, go to Manage Access, and it shows you some information here. You can see that I've got access because I'm the owner, and then there's three groups, and those three groups are the default groups that were created alongside the SharePoint site. You see some icons here that represent different levels of access. So this is view, the pencil icon is edit. To me, this isn't very clear. What I always recommend that people do is go to advanced and view it this way. So here you can see those same three groups and you see the permission levels spelled out. You've also got an option here to check permission. So if I click on this, then I can type in someone like Adele and I can see what permission Adele has to this file. So here you can see that she has full control because she's in the example hub site owners group. She also has edit because of the members group, but of course she has full control. So that'll override anything else. And you'll see a deny down here where she can't add and customize pages, which really just deals with SharePoint Designer or other types of advanced customizations. So we don't have to worry about that. There's other information on the screen that is definitely worth pointing out as well. The second line here, this document inherits permissions from its parent. And in parentheses, it shows Demo Hub, which is the name of my site. So permissions are not customized at all for this particular file. It's going to use the same permissions that were set up by the parent. And you know which permissions those are because those are the ones you're actually looking at here. You can click on Demo Hub and it'll show you the permissions on Demo Hub. And they are the exact same. Going back to the permissions on the file, the other option you have here is you could stop inheriting permissions. Now, if you want to break the permission inheritance and customize the permissions for this file alone, you can click on Stop Inheriting Permissions. It'll ask you to confirm, and now you see that the document has unique permissions. Notice that you could also start to select these options. You have more options on the toolbar, so you can delete the unique permissions, which means you go back to the inherited permissions, discarding any changes you've made to the permission screen, or you can grant permissions to a certain user or group of users, or you can go in here and say that, you know, if I want to change the permissions that members have, I can edit that. And I can change it to something else. Maybe they should just have read-only access. So you could change permissions this way, or you could simply remove permissions entirely. Remove the visitors group. And if you ever need to in the future, go back to the inherited permissions. You can just delete the unique permissions and it'll go back to having inherited permissions again from the parent container. And one thing to note about when you break inheritance is you're not restricted to just these three groups with who you can share with. You can grant permissions and you can add everyone in your organization. Although I would definitely turn off the email invitation for that. And if we refresh the screen, we'll now see that everyone has edit access to this site, and which is a domain group. So you can add in groups from Azure Active Directory. You can't add distribution lists though, because distribution lists cannot be used in a security context like we're doing here. I could also add individual users here. If I wanted to add in Diego, let's give him special access and we'll give him full control. Then let's refresh the screen and we'll see that Diego's on here as well. I would strongly discourage granting access this way because it'll end up being more work in the long run to maintain this. It's much better if you grant access through a SharePoint group, or even more preferred would be a domain group of some sort, like we did with the external group. So maybe if you had an Azure Active Directory group that is automatically maintained, like it might be a departmental group, then you don't have to worry about maintaining that when there's turnover. And if you're not sure what some of these permissions mean, what you can do is click on the site here to go back up to the site level permissions, and you'll see a permissions button here. This will show all of the different named permission sets or permission levels that are in the organization and what rights they'll give you. These are all the default ones, but you can create custom ones. And it is common from time to time to create custom permission sets because you want something a little different for a particular audience. So if we go into the edit permission, then you'll see going down the screen, all of the different permissions that that person will have when it comes to lists and libraries, and then to the site. And then personal permissions, which would be creating personal views on lists and libraries, and personal web parts. So this is handy to have as a reference if you're building permission sets. And if you're trying to improve your skill set with SharePoint, then click on this video right here to continue your journey.